What's up, guys? How are you doing? Welcome back to my channel. My name is Cess Paulo, and if this is your first time here, kindly consider subscribing to this amazing channel, turn on the notification bell, and also like this video. So we are currently at 904 subscribers, and guys, if you haven't subscribed yet, kindly hit that subscribe button so that we can get to 1,000 subscribers. And yes, it feels nice to be back here. It's been long since I ever sat in front of a camera. I've been doing videos, but I've not really been appearing, and it feels nice to be back. So yes, let's start on this video. So today's project, we're going to start working on something very new in this house. So you all know that I have been doing house transformation. I've been transforming this house, and it's finally time I started working on my dining table. And I don't plan on buying a new dining table. I just want to transform my sewing machine, which is very old. I want to transform it and make it my own dining area that is going to save me money, and I just want to do it myself, and I feel like the sewing machine stand is the perfect one. So now let's begin the video. And by the way, this top is my own design, Cess design. So if you want to check this out, check it out on Instagram at Cess Designs. Yes, that is how it looks. And let's begin this video. Now subscribe. Yay. So as you can see, guys, this is my sewing machine, and this is how it looks right now. And we're about to transform this, and I want you guys to see every process of it, because I have a dream and I feel it will look so amazing once I'm done. So let's begin. As you can see, I removed the top, the head of the machine, it's no longer there. And this one, it actually, you can detach it like that. So we're going to remove it. Next, we're going to come in with our pliers, which is what we're going to use to loosen these knobs here and here, because I want to remove this part. I want to remove all of it and only remain with these and these, so that they will act as our stand. So let's start. I have 4 screws to remove from this stand here, 2 on the upper part and 2 on the lower part, and I'm going to be using a pliers to remove them, to loosen them, but you can also use a spanner. And why I'm removing this stand, I know it can stay as it is right now, but as you can see, there is a wheel there, the wheel that you use on the sewing machine, and it's preventing someone from sitting well. It's also making the table to be super, super busy. So I have to remove these, detach it, and then I have to remove the wheel separately, because the wheel is quite tough to remove, and you cannot remove it with the legs on. That's why we have to separate these parts, but you will see in the whole process. Now we are done with 2 upper screws. As you can see, once you loosen it with the pliers, you can even use your hands to loosen it, provided that the parts are not rusted. And yes, that's how basically it is. Now we have removed the stands, the legs away from the stand with the wheel, and here it is. So now I have to work on removing the wheel and the foot pedal. You see the foot pedal is still there. Yes, so those are parts that cannot work. I cannot put chairs. As you can see, I have the 2 parts now separate. I removed the wheel, but it was quite a whole process. It was quite a big process. So the wheel is gone now, but there are still 2 parts I could not remove. There is this part right here, the one that was attaching the wheel, and these other parts, but I'm going to remove them in future. Meanwhile, we're going to work with these. These are the screws that you're going to use to tighten, and these are the pliers and the spanner for fastening, for tightening the screws and the nuts. So if you want to see the whole process of how I removed the wheel of the machine, I made a video on that, the previous video before this. As you can see, I showed you how to remove it, how to remove rusted parts. So check it out. Now I'm coming here with the screws, and I'm attaching the stand, as you can see. So I'm using my hands for the first time, and then I'm not making it too tight for the upper part, and then because we have to attach the lower part and it needs to be movable still. So after attaching the upper part slightly, you'll come and attach the lower part, and then I'll come and fasten. So here I'm in inserting the screw, and then you come and insert the hole on the other part of the stand. So you attach the stand to the legs like that, and then you're going to fasten it using your hands. Simple as that. At some point I tried using the legs without the stand and the table, but it couldn't stand. Like, the legs cannot support themselves, so either you come in and put another piece of metal, or you use the same stand that I'm using here, the one that was still on the sewing machine. Now that we are done attaching the upper part of the stand, let's attach the lower part. And I had, like, this one cannot stand straight based on how the machine was made. I have to put this slanting like this, which actually works to my advantage, because when I put the chair that's going to be at the back, it's going to help someone to move their feet as compared to if it was standing straight. So as you can see, I am just fastening it, and now we are going to attach the last part, put in the screw, attach it, use our hands to fasten it, and then come in with our spanner to tighten it. Yeah, the spanner is easier to tighten with than the, what is it called, oh god, the pliers. And as I told you guys in the previous video, these parts of the sewing machine that I'm going to use as a dining table, I can always come and assemble them back and take them back and make them a sewing machine again, because I have all the spare parts. No part has been destroyed. It's just reattaching them, attaching them again. And here we are now just tightening the upper part. As I told you, now after you've attached the lower part, you've made it tight kabisa, you can come now and make sure the upper part is tight. Totally tight, as you can see here. And I filmed this part during the night, that's why you see there's a change of light, because there's only two sources of light, so don't mind the lighting. But anyway, our stand has now been attached. It's very tight, it cannot move, it's stable. Even if I put the stand now here on top, the stand of the machine, to make my table complete, as you can see, I can even move up, I can literally even do exercise on this, and it's not moving. So it's been successful, easy busy DIY. I hope you love it, guys. Tell me what you think in the comment section so far about this project. This is the stand now. It is ready, and now we need to come in and put the base, the table. So I'm going to be using the same table, the same tabletop that was there on the sewing machine, as you can see here, because I've not yet bought the right top for my machine, for my table. It's now my dining table, it's no longer my sewing machine. But yes, I will get the right stand and then I'll show you. And as you can see, you can even sit on this. So now that you have seen how I achieved my dining table, it's time for me now to show you the other beautiful part, which I will show you in the next video right after this. So kindly check it out. I'm going to upload it right now, so just check it out and see what other nice thing I have for the dining table. And I cannot wait to finish this project. So bye bye guys, I'll see you next time.